Henri Paul was not only unqualified, three separate blood tests showed he was 3 to 4 times over the drink limit. Despite that, conspiracy theorists are now suggesting that in some mysterious way, his blood sample was tampered with. Even were this so, there is overwhelming evidence that Paul was drunk. That night, he had been off duty and drinking. When he was summoned back to the Ritz, he slipped into the Bar Vendôme for a couple more drinks. He sat at table number 1 near the bar. Our camera shows that bar staff have a clear view of their customers. Al-Fayed's acting security chief and Trevor Rees-Jones have stated that Henri Paul was drinking pineapple juice, which he topped up with water. They had no reason to believe that Paul was drunk. But bar staff have told French police that Paul drank 2 pastis, which, when mixed with water, resembled pineapple juice. And we have obtained details of a statement made to French police by Alain Villomez, a barman working in the Bar Vendôme that night. He says,
"It was well known that Monsieur Paul liked to drink. I saw him drunk inside the hotel on several occasions."
Villomez states that,
"As Monsieur Paul left the bar, he knocked into Monsieur L'Hôtelier, the senior barman, and staggered to the exit."
Villomez goes on to say that he was requested by senior Ritz management to tell any inquirers that Paul had been drinking fruit juice and showed no signs of disability. He was told,
"It was important to stick to this version for the good of the royal family."
At just after midnight on the 31st of August, Frederick the chauffeur arrived with the Mercedes at the back entrance of the Ritz to hand the keys to the drunken Henri Paul.
When I arrived at Rue Cambon, Mr. Paul, the princess, Dodi and the bodyguard were already waiting behind the glass door, and I saw them, so I stopped the car just in front of the exit. I opened my door and I've been waiting along the car maybe 15 seconds until Diana's and Dodi's arrival. So I opened the door of the car, the back door, and then Diana and Dodi's entered in the car very fast, and the bodyguard sit on the front seat.
Trevor Rees-Jones.
Trevor Rees-Jones, you're right.
Some paparazzi claimed that Henri Paul then issued a dangerous challenge. Fayed's spokesman denied this.
"You will remember that it was reported as a matter of fact that Henri Paul taunted the paparazzi as he drove away, saying they would never catch him, or words to that effect. You will see from the evidence that there were no paparazzi in the immediate vicinity when Monsieur Paul drove away, and he drove off in a quite normal way. These allegations made headlines worldwide, but when the truth has been demonstrated, it has been less well reported or even ignored."
In fact, it later emerged that there were 3 photographers waiting at the back exit of the Ritz. Al-Fayed's team has never changed its story that Henri Paul did not challenge the paparazzi and definitely did not drive off quickly. Tonight, Frederick describes what he saw. Tell me in your own words what Henri Paul said when he took over the charge of the car from you that you brought to the back of the Ritz.
Well, he told me, "I keep the car, I drive the car," so I answered, "I know." And he was standing up close to the car and he told to the photographer, "Don't try to follow us, you'll never catch us." That's what I remember he said to the photographer.
And when he started driving, did he drive normally? Did he drive fast?
They left very fast.
So yeah. He put his foot down?
Yeah. Okay, here is the Rue Cambon.
Frederick then identified himself on the Ritz security video. It records one picture frame every second. The photographers are just out of the camera's sight on the left.
Here is the Mercedes arriving. I'm on the wheel. And here is Mr. Paul. And he's looking at the photographs. There is the princess. And I'm now outside of the car and I'm opening the gate, the doors. And Mr. Paul is going to talk to the photographer and tell them don't try to follow us, you won't catch us. And then look how the car is going to drive very fast. And here I am, yeah. Yeah, it's me, yeah. Blue suit, I remember, yeah. I'm looking at the departure of the cars, and now I'm looking for the door to come back to the Place Vendôme. Yeah.
Frederick's testimony directly contradicts this man, Philippe Siegel, an Étoile Limousine director who told French police that he bought up the Mercedes from the garage.
Now, you are aware that a man called Philippe Siegel has given a statement to the police in which he says that he did exactly what you just told us you did. In other words, that he brought the car from the underground car park and handed it over to Henri Paul.
Yeah, I just learned that a few days ago. Maybe it does explain the reason why I haven't been asked by the police earlier. So of course, if someone else testified that he broke the car, the police had no reason to look for me.
Frederic has now made a sworn statement to the police, which has been handed to the French judge investigating the crash. Dispatches understands that as a result, Siegel and other witnesses from the Étoile Limousine and Ritz Hotel managements have been re-interviewed by the judge. They were not informed of Frederick's evidence, and they stuck to their original statements. Frederick's eyewitness account confirms that Henri Paul, a drunk driver, was intent on outracing the paparazzi. Despite all the efforts of Mohamed Al-Fayed and other fantasists to create myths and stoke up conspiracies, that is the sad, unalterable reality of how Henri Paul, Dodi Fayed, and Princess Diana came to die.